Boxing, you know, because I mean, people, I think, so I mean, so excited to be back in it, and it's nothing better than this, you know.
A warrior in the ring. What's next for you? Where have you been, and what's next?
Well, we've been training, getting ready. Hopefully, we will fight in July in Phoenix, Arizona. That's the plan for now. Been trying to knock some doors, you know, but it's been a little bit hard. I mean, just coming back, boxing is coming back, and we open, you know, to get a. I mean, when I get the big fight, but when I get somebody, they put us in that position. But the problem is right now is to get those prospects to fight me. Seems like they don't want to put them to me. I mean, that's the way I feel it is. You know?
There's no fight none bigger than Jake Paul. I think that would be great. Jake Paul needs a real fighter.
Hey, I fight anybody. Just show me the money. I fight anybody. You know me. I never choose my opponents. Always show me who I'm going to fight. I'm the type of fighter that I fight anybody. You know what I mean? I don't care.
What do you think about Jake Paul? Looks like he has 1 punch knockout power.
Well, you know what I mean? Against who? I mean, I'm going to keep it real, man. Like, my respect for him, I respect his hustle. But he's doing right. I mean, they're doing his career. They're already, like, they do, like, for every prospect. He's doing so far so good. He's showing so good good talent on his own level. You know what I mean? So it's good for him, you know? No, I respect him because, I mean, to go in the ring, man, it's not easy. It's a lot of pressure, so it's hard. So, I mean, like I said, a lot of people start can be bad about it, you know, and all that. But, I mean, he's doing what he takes, you know. He's training. He's showing all the what he got in there. He's fighting the right opponents. And you never know. Maybe someday he come back with a real, real champion. You never know, man.
Speaking of pressure, you know something about pressure of boxing and the pressure of holding such a difficult position. Talk to me a little bit about Ryan Garcia pulling out of the Javier Fortuna fight.
Well, you know what? I think, I mean, Ryan Garcia to me is very, I mean, is a young prospect, is a young guy that is coming up. All I'm gonna say is this, you know, is not boxing, talking about boxing is not what everybody's saying. It is not to me yet, but it will be. It's not there yet. But I think he's pushing him way too fast, and the lightweight division is too hard. Maybe, you know, like, it's a lot of pressure, you know, being in that position. Maybe get to him. And he need that some time off, you know, and that's what it is. You know, maybe he's going to hopefully come back and, you know, fresh and strong mentally. And just, to me, just take his time a little bit longer, and then he can fight the top guys, you know what I mean?
Is he the number one fighter in that division, or who would you say that? Ryan? The young guys.
I mean, it's hard to say that because, I don't think so because, I mean, it's Lomachenko still there, you know. David Haney, Teofimo. I mean, come on, they're real lions, man. Okay. Tank is there. I don't put Ryan in that number one. I mean, no, maybe number five. I mean, the difference with Brian and all those guys, Ryan is very popular. There's a difference. Being popular than being like a real solid fighter. That's the difference. People kind of mix that, you know, they confuse that.